So we look at the problem of classification and closeness testing on large alphabets in this work. The problem of classification is has a lot of applications. So here we have two training sequences, X1 and X2, from two classes. And given a training sequence, we want to find out whether it was generated from class 1 or class 2. Now, it's fundamentally related to another basic problem, which is closeness testing. Here, the problem is that you are given two sequences and you want to find out whether they are generated by the same distribution or not. The problem is fairly simple when the alphabet size is small. For example, if it's a binary alphabet, let's say it's a set of coin tosses, it's easy to say whether it's a fair coin or a biased coin. But the problem is more complicated when the alphabet size is large. There, the counts of various symbols, they are not really representative of the distribution. So instead, and in fact, we can see that for large alphabets, it doesn't quite work out. So instead, what you need to look at is another statistic, which is the number of symbols which have appeared once, number of symbols which have appeared twice, and so on. So that's the information which we call profile. And our technique is basically to find out the distribution which maximizes the likelihood of observing the profile. So, this is our main result. What we claim for the problem of classification and closeness testing is that as long as anyone can distinguish two distributions with error probability less than delta using n samples, we can also get an error probability which is close to it. We can get an error probability of square root delta times, say, factor which is sub-exponential in the sample size n. And we also have a computationally efficient test for doing the same. And we also have some experimental results for the application of text classification. Here what we do is we try to classify newspaper articles into various categories like sports, politics, religion, and so on. And we can see that it performs. These are the accuracies. Green is for higher accuracy and red is for lower accuracies. We can see that our method, which is joint pattern, it actually performs very well compared to state-of-the-art methods like support vector machines.